Hello anatomy friends, this is Dr. Alsup, and in this video we will be identifying the largest and major joints of the upper limb. As is the theme for this session, we are not going into great detail here, but rather our goal is to familiarize ourselves with the basic location and the bony compartments. So starting in the shoulder region, there are two joints that I want you to begin to get familiar with, starting with the more proximal one, the acromioclavicular joint. This is where the acromial end of the clavicle articulates with the acromion of the scapula, and this will form the AC joint. This is a joint that we palpated on the very first day of anatomy, as it's an easier one to locate. You can palpate your clavicle and continue laterally until you reach a bump and you are at the acromioclavicular joint. The AC joint is not a particularly mobile joint. You can see it here as well. But its slight movements are important in allowing the full range of motion at the most mobile joint of the body, which is the glenohumeral or shoulder joint. And you've got to love that shoulder joint for many reasons. It's complicated. As mentioned, it is the most mobile joint of the body, but also one of the least stable, and with decreased stability, there's an increase of injury, which is certainly true for the shoulder joint. The joint is formed by the articulation of the glenoid fossa of the scapula, and which is relatively shallow, particularly in comparison to the relatively large humeral head. So the fit is not the best, so there are numerous accessory structures and the rotator cuff throughout to provide stability. So you can see here where the shoulder joint would be, but of course we had that joint capsule right there. And you can see a little bit of the head right there articulating with the glenoid cavity. Moving distally, we reach the elbow region, where you really have three joints in one region. The major joint, and the one that we mean when we say elbow joint, is the humero-ulnar joint, which is right here. Now, this joint is more medially placed, so this is going to be medial. This will be lateral, mainly because you have that trochlea here, the medial epicondyles right here. And this is what's really forming that true hinge joint. Not on the list, but neighboring, is the humeroradial joint, which will further support the movements of the elbow joint. Just distal to both of these is the proximal radio ulnar joint. So proximal radio ulnar joint. The radius and the ulna will articulate in three separate areas, which in essence forms three different joints. The proximal radial ulnar, as the name would suggest, is the most proximal of these, and this is formed by the head of the radius and the radial notch of the ulna, and it allows that head to rotate, the head of the radius to rotate. These are the other two joints formed by the radius and the ulna. The longest and only observable and deepest dissections is the interosseous membrane, which is this whole kind of sheet of connective tissue that is connecting the bodies or the shafts of the radius and the ulna. This is actually not a synovial joint. It's a fibrous joint. It will further allow the actions that can occur between the radius and the ulna. The distal radio ulnar joint is the distal most, right above the wrist joint, and this is formed by the ulnar notch of the radius and the head of the ulna. So right here is the distal radio ulnar. All three of these radio ulnar joints will allow the movements of pronation and supination that we will discuss in more detail in upcoming sessions. Lastly, we have the wrist joint, which is also called the radiocarpal joint because it is formed by the distal end of the radius and the first or proximal row of the carpal bones, which would be deep to this region here. So in essence, the radiocarpal or wrist joint is right here in this region. as you can see, it's quite protected by ligaments as well as kind of fascia in this region, but it is still one of your larger synovial joints. Excellent. Here is an overview with a bit more context regarding the joints we just discussed in terms of relationships with other bones. The AC and glenohumeral joints are up here that are proximally located. In the elbow region, we have the complex of three joints. We have that humero-ulnar, the humero-radial. I assure you this is spelled right. I don't know why that that little line is there. And then we have, not circled here, but the proximal radio-ulnar right there. The interosseous membrane would be kind of right in this region here. So it'd be that connective tissue connecting these, the shafts or the bodies of these bones, with the distal radio-ulnar right here. And then, of course, we have the radiocarpal or wrist joint, which is formed by that distal radius and this first row, the first or proximal row of carpal bones, those small bones of the wrist. And note that this ulna does not play an articulating role in the radiocarpal or wrist joint. All right, great. Thank you for your time and attention here, and have a great rest of your day.